Please be seated. Good afternoon. It is good to be in Goochland County. Christine, thank you so much for your wonderful words and just exciting news and also for your leadership. We really appreciate that. I also want to thank Chief Eddie Ferguson from Station 6 and all the folks that serve the localities here. Thank you for your hospitality this afternoon and welcome us, Eddie. I also want to take this opportunity. They don't get thanked enough. These types of announcements and accomplishments do not happen in a vacuum, and we just got a great team. But starting with our policy director, Courtney Dozier is in here somewhere. Just raise your hand when I call your name. Evan Feynman, who is kind of our guru of broadband, Kyle Rossner, and also Tamara Holmes. So please give them a round of applause for all of their time. I also want to thank Gary Wood, just tremendous leadership, and I think everybody knows him here, but he has actually served Central Virginia Electric Co-op since 1987, so please put your hands together for Gary Wood. And you know, it's not too often you have three governors from the Commonwealth of Virginia. So to have our U.S. Senator, Senior Senator Mark Warner, and our U.S. Senator Tim Kaine with us today, that lets you know how much this means to the Commonwealth of Virginia. So you'll hear from both of those in just a minute, but also our Congresswoman Abigail Spanberger. Thank you all. And I just want folks to know that, you know, this has been a team effort. It starts at the local level. We have input from the state level and then at the national level. And they have just, the three of them, have just been so instrumental in whether it has been across Virginia and then now this announcement on broadband. So we've just had a great relationship with our congressional delegation and really appreciate all you do and also appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule to be with us today. We're here today. I'm going to not trespass on too much of your time, but this is an exciting milestone for the Commonwealth of Virginia, and while I make my comments, I'd like you all to focus on this map of Virginia to my right, and I'll show you a different map. This is where we started in 2018, and I'm going to show you a map in just a second of where we are today, and you'll see how far we've come. This has always been very personal to me. I'm from the Eastern Shore, this little piece of Virginia that's not connected to the rest of the Commonwealth by land anyway, and oftentimes when we look at maps of Virginia, they actually leave the Eastern Shore off, which I get very defensive about. But you can see, now I grew up in the suburbs of Onancock, Virginia, on a small farm, and when I started in 2018, we didn't have broadband, and we do now, which I'm pleased to have. But, you know, we always knew that broadband was important for everybody, no matter who you are, no matter where you are in Virginia. It has become a necessity. We saw that during COVID, whether it's our children that are having to learn virtual. And believe it or not, families were having to go to fast food restaurants and getting on hotspots so that their children could have access to broadband. That is something we should all find is unacceptable. Telehealth became very popular during COVID-19, and that worked fine if you had access to broadband, but if you didn't, you didn't receive care. And for business opportunities, quality of life, it has just been so important. And so when I started in 2018, I went to some of these individuals that I just mentioned. I said, how long will it take to get universal broadband in Virginia? And they said 10 years. And I said, oh, I said, I don't even know where I'm going to be in 10 years, but we've got to do it sooner than that. So we've been able to work together, and I would just describe it, and the reason the help from Washington is so important, if you look at the history of electrification back in the early 1900s, rural Virginia was way behind the rest of the country in receiving electricity, and it was the Congress, that stepped up and said, especially for rural Virginia or rural United States, and especially for farmers, we need to make sure that they have electricity. And so we have really taken the same approach. And when we talk about the revenue, the resources that it takes for universal broadband in Virginia, when I started in 2018, Virginia was investing less than $4 million a year. Now, I went to the legislature and said, we need $50 million a year. Well, you don't always get what you want, as you all remember, governors in Richmond. And we compromised at $19 million. We then went up to $35 million, and then this last year, $50 million. So we've made a lot of progress, but now we know that with the funding from Washington earlier this year, remember we started at $4 million. Earlier this year, we committed $700 million in federal funding to the effort. So paired with commitments from private partnerships and other sources, we'll be able to close the digital divide much faster than we could have imagined 4 years ago. In fact, and I'm gonna go ahead and take this down. In fact, we have closed more than 90% of the digital divide. We have made certain that every Virginian will have broadband access by 2024. Since 2018, our administration has awarded $846 million in broadband grants and connected over 429,000 homes and businesses. And today, we're making major awards announcements to finish that job. This morning, we announced $722 million in awards, leveraging $1 billion in matching dollars to connect 278,000 homes and businesses. Now, these awards will bring universal coverage to 70 Virginia counties from Lee to Accomack, Frederick to Halifax. This includes the projects we're celebrating today, one of the largest broadband projects we've seen in Virginia. So we're awarding $79 million to Central Virginia Electric Cooperative and Firefly to connect more than 36,000 homes and businesses to fiber internet. This award will leverage $208 million in private and local matching funds. Listen to this, it will connect all unserved locations in Albemarle, Amherst, Appomattox, Buckingham, Campbell, Cumberland, Fluvanna, Goochland, Greene, Louisa, Madison, Nelson, and Powhatan counties. And so I want to recognize Firefly and Central Virginia Electric Co-op for taking on this challenge, just like they did 80 years ago during rural electrification. Firefly just celebrated their 10,000th customer and will have a lot of work ahead of them in the next 2 years. I know they can get the job done, and we thank all the Firefly and CVAC employees and board members for their work to make this happen. Again, this could not have happened without our partners in Congress passing the American Rescue Plan, which helped provide this funding. So again, I want to thank Senators Warner, Senator Kaine, and Representative Spanberger for your invaluable leadership in D.C. and helping Virginia get this flexible broadband funding. Likewise, I want to recognize the General Assembly for funding broadband throughout the past 4 years and agreeing to allocate $700 million of the ARPA money to broadband. I'd also like to recognize the counties of Central Virginia and the Thomas Jefferson Planning District Commission for putting together one of the best projects that our team has ever reviewed to connect your citizens. There were other partners in the project also, including Dominion Energy and Rappahannock Electric Co-op, who will serve as middle-mile broadband providers and help lower costs across the board. Now, after this exciting announcement, I did want to give credit to where credit is due, and Gary, if you could come up and join me, please, at the podium. Now, the governors here will let you know that proclamations are something that we take great joy and privilege in doing, but rarely do I read a proclamation. But I think it's important to read this one. But first of all, I want to knock on these. If you could just hold this, sir, and I'm going to read this. You all make yourselves comfortable. Maybe we should take an intermission and offer some, you know, beverages. All right, here we go. Whereas Gary Wood has served his community with Central Virginia Electric Co-op, CVEC, since 1987 and has led the cooperative as CEO since 2008. And whereas Gary has shown consistent commitment and leadership in his community, having served on both the Nelson County School Board and Board of Supervisors, I know you've got some bruises to show for that. And whereas Central Virginia was in dire need of improved connectivity for the economic, social, and fiscal well-being of its citizens, and whereas it became clear that the Commonwealth's existing internet service providers would not meet the needs of the communities that CVEC serves, and whereas bold and transformative leadership is always necessary to undertake the creation of any new enterprise, and whereas CVEC created a broadband subsidiary, Firefly, to provide this essential service to Central Virginians within and beyond their electric service footprint, and whereas Firefly has already connected more than 10,000 Virginia homes and businesses with tens and thousands more Virginians to receive high-quality broadband connections in the coming years, and whereas none of these accomplishments could have occurred under leadership less visionary. And now, therefore, I, Ralph S. Northam, do hereby recognize Gary Wood and his dedicated service in our Commonwealth of Virginia, and I call this observance to the attention of all our citizens. Please give Gary Wood a round of applause.
Thank you.
Without further ado, I want to introduce the 69th governor of the Commonwealth of Virginia, now our senior U.S. Senator in Washington. Please welcome to the podium His Excellency. Let me try that again. That didn't even come out right. His Excellency, the Honorable Mark Warner. Mark, welcome.
You can tell a little bit of our difference. Thank you, Governor. I love being called His Excellency. Ralph, not so much. But Governor, thank you for your leadership. I want to talk about that in a moment. It's great to be back in Goochland, to be here with my friend of 42 years, Tim Kaine, and Abigail, who's done a great, great job in a short time in the Congress. This is for me, is like a culmination of many, many, many years. Some of you know, before I was in politics, I did have a real job. I was involved in the wireless industry and telecom. And I can remember as early as the 90s, as we were thinking about this notion of an internet-connected world. And there was a lot of promise. And for a long time, what we ended up seeing, though, was this promise we saw manifest itself as connections were made in places like Mumbai in India or Shanghai in China. They got the benefits of a connected, internet-driven world. But rural communities all over Virginia, for that matter, all over the country, didn't get those benefits.